good afternoon. Hope everyone had a very good lunch. The session after lunch is always usually the toughest. Everyone wants a nap, but I guess that's why we've got him here. You know, the only male person we have on this panel to talk about women. Reservation, if you look at this, is 25%. Parliament, they're asking for 33%, but you've got 100% star power here, I think, Ravish ji. So I'll begin with you. We're talking about second citizens, which is supposed to be about women and how they're being marginalized. If you look at the formation of this panel right now, you're the second citizen as being the only male on the panel. Would you agree that newsrooms jo hai, they're not constructed for women? They are mainly catering to men because that is how newsrooms began maybe. We joined later and it has not changed with the times. We have lots of star powers. We have a lot of superstars in media who are women, but they're not in managerial roles.
मैं इस मामले में हेलो जहाँ से आता हूँ एनडीटीवी में और मैं जहाँ से आया था एनडीटीवी में तो दोनों के जर्नी में मैंने आसपास लड़कियों को किसी भी अपने जीवन में मतलब आप इससे भी एक सैंपल ले सकते हैं कि अपने जीवन में किसी को किचन के बाहर मैनेजरियल रोल में लीडरशिप के रोल में नहीं देखा था लेकिन एनडीटीवी में आने के बाद मुझे लगता था ये कोई दूसरी दुनिया है जो इस दुनिया का हिस्सा नहीं है क्योंकि उस वक्त भी जो मेरी उम्र की लड़कियां थीं जिन 22 23 24 साल वो सब लीडिंग पोजीशन में थीं तो हैरान करने वाली बात थी वही लोग लीडर थीं आज भी हैं उनमें से बहुत सारे लोग बहुतों ने अपना पेशा भी बदला लेकिन उसी के साथ जब वहाँ से निकल कर मैं बाहर के और जगहों पर लोग जो काम करते थे मिलता जुलता था अब कम मिलना जुलना होता है तो पता चलता था कि लड़कियों के लिए इस फील्ड में वो दुनिया नहीं है जिसको देखकर मैं मुझे लगता था कि बड़ा अच्छा है एनडीटीवी में यहाँ पर फ्लोर को देखने से ही अभी भी लड़कियाँ ही ज़्यादा लगती हैं तब और ज़्यादा लगती थी लेकिन मेरे ही जो दोस्त फील्ड में जिन लड़कियों से जो बहुत काबिल थी जिनसे कुछ सीखने के लिए उस वक्त मैं अपने दोस्तों की जिनसे मैं इसलिए दोस्ती कर रहा था कि यार ये बहुत जानती हैं तो इनका पूछ पकड़ के पीछे पीछे घुमा करो थोड़ा सा कुछ सीख जाओगे लेकिन जब ये दोस्ती का पैमाना था तब ये सच बात है कि वो बहुत ज़्यादा काबिल थीं तो मुझे लगता था कि इन्हीं के साथ रह के मैं कुछ सीख सकता हूँ लेकिन जब उनसे अलग होकर जब मैं अपने कॉलीग से मिलता जुलता था जो लोग फील्ड में खड़े रहते थे तो फिर शुरू होता था साथ वाली जो दूसरे चैनल की लड़कियां हैं उनका सेक्सुअल डिपिक्शन शुरू होता था कि यार तुम उनके साथ बात कर रहे हो तो बहुत कॉन्फ्लिक्ट होने लगता था कि अपनी डिसऑनेस्टी लगती थी कि फिर मुझे उस उनके पास जाना है फिर उनके बारे में इससे ये सुनना है तो कई बार जाके बताता था कि ऐसा ऐसा बोलता मैं क्या करूँ समझ में नहीं आता है तो उन्होंने कहा आपको खुद डील करना चाहिए आप मुझे क्यों बताते हैं तो फिर धीरे धीरे हमने बोलना सीखा कि आप जो ये बात कह रहे हैं वो ठीक नहीं है मुझे नहीं लगता कि इस हालात में बहुत बदलाव आया है जो लोग भी सक्सेस तो मैं नहीं कहूँगा क्योंकि आज के टीवी के एंकर में मेल हो फीमेल हो इसके सक्सेस का थोड़ा सक्सेस कहने में थोड़ा सा घबराना चाहिए क्योंकि ज़्यादातर वो जेंडर न्यूट्रल पपेट्री शुरू हो गई है इंडियन मीडिया में लेकिन वो उन कहानियों से उनका पीछा नहीं छूटा है आज
आप पपेट्री क्यों बोल रहे हैं
पपेट्री इसीलिए कह रहे हैं कि ये गोदी मीडिया का दौर है और अगर आप पपेट नहीं हैं तो आपको निकाल दिया जाएगा हाँ और हाँ हाँ ये जैसे होता है ना डिजिटल इंडिया उसकी जगह लिख देना चाहिए बुजदिल इंडिया हम डरपोकों का एक भारत बनाते हैं आओ सारे डरपोक मिलकर एक भारत बनाते हैं और जो बोलेगा उसको उस भारत से बाहर कर देते हैं ठीक है तो ये तो बात सही है इसमें आप ना भी देखें तो भी दिख जाएगा देखना चाहें तो ज़्यादा दिख जाएगा रातों की नींद उड़ जाएगी तो ये इस पपेट्री को अब सक्सेस कहना मतलब जर्नलिस्टिक स्किल से वो सक्सेस नहीं है अब वो अब इस स्किल से उसका कंटिन्यूएशन है खासकर टीवी में जो मैं जानता हूँ वो इसलिए है कि आप कितना उनकी लाइन की तरफ हैं या उनके हिसाब से उनके एजेंडे के हिसाब से है तो ये आपके बने रहने का पैमाना है इससे डेविएट की जगह तो आप हटा दी जाएंगे फिर क्या मेल क्या फीमेल मतलब उस दोनों को समान रूप से जो बोलने वाला है उसको
खेलना पड़ेगा हाँ
उसको कोई मतलब जी
नेहा लेट मी कम टू यू यू नो यू आर द अदर जर्नलिस्ट दैट वी हैव ऑन द पैनल एंड talking about females. How has it been for you? You're also one who travels around India a lot. You go to the villages, you go to the small towns. He has been candid and conceded that yes, the newsrooms are not constructed for women out on the field, how they're objectified. You want to share some experiences with us on that front?
Thank you, Nayantara. Very happy to be here. Mere khayal se, there are a couple of things that we need to keep in mind because there are things operating at various levels. First, the thing is that each time we say, when we talk about women in media and we talk about women journalists, people often say ki are aajkal bahut sare jagah pe aa gaye hain, and we do see that. In fact, News Laundry also had a report sometime back saying that there are 32% of the employees in newsrooms are women. But the point is that a lot of them, like Ravish said, that there are some places which are exceptions. But that doesn't go to other, mainstream newsrooms or say alternate newsrooms or newsrooms in operating different languages. It doesn't work like that. There are several women reporters, women journalists, but they are in the lower rung and the middle rung. They are not in decision-making roles. They're not part of the management. They're not part of the editorial, top editorial board. So often at times they keep doing what they have to do. The other thing is that the kind of stories, the kind of beats they want to cover. That is an important thing because often at times, I've heard from many senior journalists, a lot of them are sitting here, that there was a time when they had to struggle and say that we are not going to go and cover baby show and flower show. We actually want to go and do some serious stories. So it's starting from that point in 30 years now, from that point, now still the struggle is that. For example, I'll give you a very specific example. Each time there's a story around sexual violence, gender-based violence, it is the women reporters who are asked to go and report. And I'm not saying that they shouldn't report, but it is not our job only to write about
but
gender.
But that's my other issue. No, why is it that media only covers women when there's a rape or there's a murder? Yeah, we don't celebrate women every
I'm
day.
I'm just saying that each time, if there is a woman journalist, our only job is not to write about gender. And the second thing is, when you write, for example, for my stories, I'll give you an example. I'd written a profile of Akhilesh Yadav for Caravan, and there was a bit about the Yadav family in my profile. And I got this feedback that, "Arey, ye to woman journalist hai, to ye to parivar parivar ke hi baare mein likhegi." Thankfully, I was vindicated when the family led to the downfall of the party and it breaking apart. So this is the way each time, even if you write a political story, if there is a gender prism that you use, whether you're writing a political story, whether you're writing a story on defense or development or anything, they think, "Arey, ye women ke baare mein mat likha karo." Because the problem is that our prototype is a male reader, and so everything related to women is only gender. So either it's sexual violence or maternity health. So only our reproductive parts. But if we talk about agrarian crisis and we talk about a woman farmer, or if we talk about labor and we talk about unorganized women workforce, that is seen to be a gender issue and not a labor issue. And I think that is where the problem is. And talking about you saying that going to several places, this is my trick and maybe I should out it. A lot of times, especially, and I wouldn't say just in rural areas, but also in urban areas, a lot of times when I go and talk to men, middle-aged men, toh wo sochte hai ki ye toh matlab bechari bevkoof ladki hai, isko kya pata hoga? So a lot of times they start mansplaining. So I use that mansplaining and I play the dumb girl, and they end up telling me more than they would tell a male reporter. So so that is one thing.
That is certainly a trick to being a good reporter. If I could come to you, Vinda, you know, like something Neha just talked about, and you've talked a lot about it, that the real problem is also perception, how women are perceived and how at home is where the real problem is. It starts from there. Isn't that part of the problem and where what we need to solve as well in the real fix?
Well, you mean patriarchy?
Yes.
Right? I agree with you, patriarchy needs to be fixed long time. Yes. I don't disagree with that at all. Of course, that is where the problem is, and actually Ravish pointed precisely to that when he said that where, you know, the world he came from, women played certain roles. Not because those women were not intelligent, but because their roles were predetermined, as was his. We don't know, maybe he's a great chef, we've yet to discover that. But
are you?
So what I'm saying here is that yes, those are predetermined roles that we have, which are societally determined, socially determined. And it takes a lot where people like Neha and others break out of that mold and move forward and do stories which are contested spaces, enter those contested spaces. But I think here what we need to also perhaps point to, and which again Ravish had referred to, and Neha's work itself speaks of that, that yes, today you could be a male or female journalist who could perhaps be part of a channel which would like to be pro-establishment, and therefore you take a certain position, and you actually can adopt those masculinist approaches and the masculinist demeanor of certain anchors. And we do see that happening in many channels. At the same time, when women journalists do take anti-establishment positions, while they are targeted, as would male journalists be targeted who take anti-establishment positions, I think there is a distinction in the nature of the targeting and how that targeting becomes more and more personal, individual, and sexualized. And because we are all living in a real world, the consequences of that are different for the woman. Insofar as even saying, say, certain newsrooms are more liberal, and again, this has already been said, the question to be asked is, does misogyny and sexism actually totally leave the newsroom? Can it leave the newsroom? It doesn't leave the courtroom ever, no matter what the law is. And everybody sitting in the courtroom knows the law. So does it mean that simply because you have more women in a particular newsroom, and you certainly don't have them in too many newsrooms, does it mean that all the undercurrents of sexism and misogyny leave us, which is precisely where patriarchy is? It's in each one of us. And therefore, we need to keep that filter alive, even in newsrooms which look more liberal spaces. Yeah. And then does it permeate to those who are in technical spheres? Do you really have more camera persons who are women? I don't know. But it doesn't look like that for those of us who are looking at TV news channels, for instance, from the outside. I don't see more camera women, more light women. Of course, now everybody's function is, one person has to perform sound, light, everything together. But I still don't see many women there. They may be on the editing table, I don't know. So those elements are still prevalent, and therefore we need to be very aware and alert to some of those, I feel.
I'm going to come to the birthday girl. Yes, it's her birthday today. I told you I would announce it on stage. Yes, you can be embarrassed all you want. So we'll give you more time to speak as well.